multiple different imaging techniques. So a lot of people will start out with a chest X-ray. It's not the best test for lung imaging, but it's certainly a good test. It's been around forever. CT is generally the best test to look at the lungs. And then when we actually have a diagnosis, we do something called conventional imaging or functional imaging. And this is either done through the old way, which is the octree scan, or the newest way and which really replaces the octree scan is something called the gallium 68 DOTA tape PET CT. So lymph nodes are, you know, we can find lymph nodes scattered throughout the body. It's normal to have lymph nodes. So it's when those lymph nodes enlarge, we say, all right, why are they enlarged? Are they enlarged because you have infection or inflammation, or could there be cancer associated with this? So that's why I say whenever we do a cancer operation, whether it be in the GI tract or lung, we need to sample those lymph nodes and see if there's any involvement, if there's spread. So normally in a lung carcinoid, where I see lymph node involvement is we look at, there's three orders of lymph nodes within the lung. We look at something called the hilar nodes, which are that first order of lymph nodes. Then the second order, so the cancers, they tend to start out. So if you got a cancer in the right side of the chest, it will spread to those lymph nodes on the right side of the chest first. The second place it spreads is to the mediastinal lymph nodes. So that we always look at the hilar nodes. We sample the mediastinal nodes when we do a surgery. And then the next place it will spread is to the nodes up by near the collarbone, so the supraclavicular nodes, or to the other side, the mediastinum. So it's three orders of lymph nodes. If this spreads elsewhere, so to the axilla, you mentioned the diaphragm, that's considered distant disease or metastatic disease, okay, rather than local regional disease. Chest CT is generally the standard of care. If most of the time, so what I normally do is I'll monitor with chest CTs. If I get a gallium preoperatively, or if I get a gallium for another reason, and I see something on the gallium that I'm not seeing on the chest CT, well, then that patient is going to be getting galliums from here on out. I guess it depends. Normally you can see a discrete nodule or mass. So I guess every now and again you can be fooled. And that's where your gallium PET comes in sometimes. And obviously nothing. If you've got a biopsy of what they're described as a scar that says NET, well, there's your answer. So that's a very good question. So common things being common, it is most likely a metastatic site. Now there's certain tests that we can sometimes do that will look to determine the tumor of origin or the site of origin. So we do this from time to time, and just as in these particular cases, as we say, all right, well, could this have spread from the bowel to the lung? And we would run this test and say, this started in the lung or this started in the bowel. So that could be, something that we would look at. I think the biggest thing is to, we also look at some of what this looks like underneath the microscope. So are we dealing with initially a well-differentiated tumor, and now we have a poorly differentiated tumor? Sometimes that gives us an idea, well, maybe this is more of a primary tumor. If we think it's primary, we treat it as a primary tumor.